Okay.
So I'm able to do like the number one part all the way, but the B question that talks about less than or greater than, because the number one, I'm able to do like two sample tests and I'm able to get the answer.
Okay.
But when it comes to get like the larger or the least numbers, the one you have to key in the two numbers, I don't know where to go in the calculator.
Okay, so if I'm hearing you right, you were able to do part A, and your question's about the next part.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, then let me catch up with you.
Okay.
So data on the weights of the contents of cans, diet soda versus, okay, this and that. Assume that either independent, simple random samples from a normally distributed population, do not assume the population and deviations are equal. Okay, so test the claim that the contents of the cans diet series have weights with a mean that is less than the mean for the regular. Gotcha. All right, so test the claim that the contents for the diet series have a mean that is less than the mean for this one. Okay, so mu one and mu two. Oh, I see. Mu one goes with diet, mu two goes with regular. Got it. Okay. So when they say diet is less than, they're saying mu one is less than mu two. So that would be the alternative hypothesis. The null hypothesis always has an equal sign, so it must be C. Okay. And so there, and so now you, so you're stuck here. You're trying to find the test statistic.
No. The test I'm able to do because that one I'm doing under the two sample tests. So
Good.
I key in the data on the calculator.
Uh-huh.
That way I'm able to do the T test.
Okay. Good. Okay, so your question's in the a later part then. Okay, let's see. All right, let's see if I can get caught up to you then. So you went to stat tests. Oops, wrong button. Stat
Two
tests.
sample test.
Two sample T test.
Test.
Is that right?
No, two sample. Yeah, T test. Yeah.
Yeah, because we don't know the population standard deviation, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so therefore we use this one. In this case, we have the stats. We don't have the data.
Yeah.
So this time, X1 is
Is
going to
zero
be.
point 7 9 4 0 1.
Okay, and the standard deviation for that one.
Is 0.00438.
Okay, and in this case,
24.
okay, and then that one, 81, 685, is that right?
I'm not able to see that part.
Oh, you can't see it?
No.
Oh, really? Oh,
Yeah.
I thought you could see what I can see.
I can just see the first part of the mu one. The mu two is you have covered it.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. That's weird, because you should be able to see
Yeah,
it.
now it's okay.
Okay, all right. Okay, so standard deviation for two.
Is 0.00747.
Okay, also with 24.
Yeah.
But in this case, the alternative hypothesis is different.
Is less than.
Yep. And it's not pooled. Because it says here that they are do not assume the population standard deviations are equal. Okay. And we can calculate these. And so you already found the test statistic. And you got, let's see here, it looks like it wants it to two decimal places. It's going to be a negative 12.92. Okay. Cool. And then you got the p-value?
Yes.
All right. It's basically zero if we round off. So extremely unlikely that this happened by chance. So you're asking about this part?
No.
Oh, okay. All right. Let's see here. I'll get to you eventually. All right. So because it's so small, we're going to reject.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, it's we reject it.
Yeah, but we'll make sure we reject it for the right reason. So there is sufficient evidence to support the claim that the cans of diet soda have amine weights that are lower than the mean weights for regular soda. So I think it's this one, right?
Mm-hmm. That part.
Oh, so you're asking about the confidence interval.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's just buttons on your calculator, right?
Yeah.
So stat, tests, but instead of going to 2-SAMP t-test,
mm-hmm.
you're looking for 2-SAMP t-int. Int is short for interval.
Okay.
It's further down. There it is. Same numbers.
2-sample int?
Yes, t-int.
Okay.
How's it coming along? Are you typing those in?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me know when you're ready.
I'm okay.
Okay. So you're at the point now
mm-hmm.
where you need to enter the confidence level.
Yeah.
Right now I have 0.99 left over from yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
But what should the confidence level be?
I can't see it.
Well, I scrolled over to the hypothesis test.
Mm-hmm.
And is this a one-tail or a two-tail hypothesis test?
Two-tail?
What makes you say two-tail?
I think because it has like two different data.
I see what you're saying. You're looking in the wrong place. Okay. Don't look at the table.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the alternative hypothesis. Look at H1. Can you see it on my screen?
Yeah.
Right there, you see the inequality right there?
Yeah, it's equal or less than.
No.
Mm-hmm.
It's just less than,
mm-hmm.
not equal to.
Mm-hmm.
Because of that less than symbol, it's a one-tail test.
Okay.
It would only be a two-tail test if there's an unequal to symbol.
Okay.
All right. So this is a one-tail test. Now, I don't have a whiteboard with me. Otherwise, I would draw a picture.
It's okay.
I'm trying to think of how I can draw a picture. I think I could draw a picture actually. So basically, let me draw a picture like this. So here I'm going to draw a picture.
Okay.
And on this picture, I'm going to draw my T distribution because we're dealing with a T distribution here. Okay. Mm-hmm. And this is a T distribution with how many degrees of freedom? I don't remember. I think the degrees of freedom was one less than the smallest number in our sample.
Yeah.
So 23 degrees of freedom. Doesn't matter so much. I'm just using this to illustrate things, okay?
Okay.
But this is my T distribution. This is the sort of picture that I usually would draw in class. Okay. Yeah. And there's a picture right there. Can you see that?
Mm-hmm.
And based on that picture,
mm-hmm.
I can, it's either going to be a one-tail test or a two-tail test. Now, because this is, has, I'm just going to say -2 to 2. All right, well, on this picture, it's actually shading in everything in between. What I'd rather actually shade in everything on this side and everything over there on that side.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense? But yeah. In fact, oh gosh, maybe I can, let me tinker with this a little bit more. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay, so this is our picture. Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah.
We have a one tail test, and in fact, it's a left tail test is what we're looking at here. Mm-hmm. Just being perfectionist now. Don't even want to see the y-axis. So based on that test, mm-hmm. right? So we have a one tail test. We're testing the hypothesis at the 5% significance level.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah.
Which means that the area of this red region should be 5%.
Yeah.
Okay? So we'll ignore this, all right? So this isn't necessarily drawn to scale.
Mm-hmm.
But assuming that that's 5%, you're now trying to find a confidence interval for which this would be the lower bound.
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
But the confidence interval always has two tails.
Yeah.
So it's going to have a lower bound on the left side and an upper bound on the right side.
Mm-hmm.
So again, tell me, what's the area of this left tail?
0.05.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's what's given in the problem. But if I'm going to construct a confidence interval, I'm going to draw another tail over here to have the upper bound.
Okay.
So, and that tail is also going to be 0.05.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, the area in the middle?
0.90.
That's right. That's right. So at this point, it's going to be 0.90. That's your confidence level.
Okay.
And from that, we can calculate our confidence interval. Does that make sense?
Yeah. So it's not like the other one where we do like 0.90 plus 0.05?
Right. Yeah, because we're not, you're thinking of like you doing inverse t or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a different function.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Then I had another question at 11.2,
okay.
Number 4.